Like never before, India celebrated its democracy by coming out to vote in large numbers. Voters' turnout was highest at 67.9%. Every section, young, old, first-time voters, voters since the first general election, women, all turned up to stamp their approval of a performing government. Through their unambiguous and firm mandate, they have reaffirmed putting the nation first. The people of India have validated the two goals for our country's future, that of national security and economic growth. The first term of Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi led NDA government stood out as a performing government, a government whose signature was in the last mile delivery. Between 2014 and 19, we provided a rejuvenated center stage dynamic, cooperative federalism, GST council, and a strident commitment to fiscal discipline. We had set the ball rolling for a new India, planned and assisted by the Niti Aayog, a broad-based think tank. We have showed by our deeds that the principle reform on many programs and initiatives we had worked on unprecedented scale. Average amount spent on food security per year approximately doubled during 2014-19 compared to the preceding 5 years. Number of patents issued more than trebled 3 times in 2017-18 as against the number of patents issued pre-14. Our last mile delivery stood out, and the unknown citizen in every nook and corner of our country felt the difference. Our objective was and continues to be mazboot desh ke liye mazboot nagrik. Mega programs and services which we initiated and delivered during those 5 years will now be further accelerated. We shall further simplify procedures, incentivize performance, reduce red tape, and make the best use of technology, just as we did earlier. I am confident we will achieve our goals. Chanakya Niti Sutra says, Karya Purusha Karena Lakshyam Sampadayate. Meaning, with determined human efforts, the task will surely be completed. An Urdu couplet, pardon me my pronunciation, Yakin ho to koi rasta nikalta hai. Yakin ho to koi rasta nikalta hai. Hawa ki oat bhi lekar charag jalta hai. Vision for the decade. Our economy was at approximately $1.85 trillion when we formed the government in 2014. Within 5 years, it has reached $2.7 trillion. Hence, it is well within our capacity to reach the $5 trillion in the next few years. In the interim budget of 2019-20, presented in February 2019, we gave ourselves a vision for the decade. I flag here the 10 points of our vision laid before us: building physical, social, and social infrastructure, digital India reaching every sector of the economy, pollution-free India with green Mother Earth and blue skies, Make in India with particular emphasis on MSMEs, startups, defense manufacturing, automobiles, electronics, fabs and batteries, and medical devices, water, water management, clean rivers, blue economy, space programs, Gaganyaan, Chandrayaan, and satellite programs, self-sufficiency, and export of food grains, pulses, oil seeds, fruits and vegetables, healthy society, Ayushman Bharat, well-nourished women and children, safety of citizens, Team India with Jan Bhagidari. Minimum government, maximum governance. These were the vision we set before ourselves. With this vision set before us, with the mandate given by its people, we are determined to take India to that height that it richly deserves. I strongly believe that with the clear-headed leadership of Honourable Prime Minister, we can achieve our goal. So what are the plans to reach the 5 trillion economy? The Indian economy will grow to become a $3 trillion economy in the current year itself. It is now the sixth largest in the world. 5 years ago, it was at the 11th position. In purchasing power parity terms, we are in fact the third largest economy already, only next to China and the USA. To attain this and more, we need to continue undertaking many structural reforms. In the last 5 years, we saw many big reforms in particular, indirect taxation, bankruptcy, and real estate. While these reforms were happening here in the Parliament, the common man's life was being changed through mudra loans to help him to do his business, and through several programs it was being ensured that his or her kitchen had become smokeless, his or her house got electricity connection, and women's dignity was respected with the provision of toilets in home. The common man was served even as a major transformational reforms were being rolled out. And for this to continue, we need to invest heavily in infrastructure, in digital economy, and on job creation in small and medium firms. Respected Speaker, sir, it took us over 55 years for the Indian economy to reach $1 trillion. But when the country and her people's hearts are filled with asha, vishwas, and akanksha, that is, when the hearts are filled with hope, trust, and aspirations, we, in 5 years, in just 5 years, added $1 trillion. As I said, today we are nearing a $3 trillion level. So when we aspire to reach a $5 trillion level, many wonder if it's possible. If we can appreciate our citizens' purushartha or their goals of human spirit or pursuit, filled with their inherent desire to progress, led by the dedicated leadership present in this house, the target is eminently achievable. All of India's private sector industries, small, medium, or large, have played a substantial role in growing our economy. I recall the words of an eminent industry leader who said that his company's growth has always aligned itself with India's growth before and post-independence. So if before independence, India Inc. understood Swadeshi, today they understand Make in India. We do not look down upon legitimate profit earning. Gone are the days of policy paralysis and license quota control regimes. India Inc. are India's job creators. They are the nation's wealth creators. Together with mutual trust, we can gain, catalyze fast, and attain sustained growth. I wish to propose a number of initiatives as part of a framework for kick-starting the virtuous cycle of domestic and foreign investments. Connectivity is the lifeblood of our economy. The government has given a massive push to all forms of physical connectivity through Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, industrial corridors, dedicated freight corridors, Bharatmala and Sagarmala projects, Jal Marg Vikas, and Udan schemes. while the industrial corridors would improve infrastructure availability for greater industrial investment in the catchment regions, the dedicated freight corridors would mitigate the congestion of a railway network benefiting the common man. The ambitious program of Bharatmala would help develop national road corridors and highways, while Sagarmala would enhance port connectivity, modernization and port-linked industrialization. If Sagarmala is aimed at improving the infrastructure for external trade, equally, it is the poor man's transport too. The Jalmarg Vikas project for capacity augmentation of navigation on national waterways is aimed at smoothening internal trade carried through inland water transport. These initiatives will improve logistics tremendously, reducing the cost of transport and increasing the competitiveness of domestically produced goods. The Udaan scheme is providing air connectivity to smaller cities and enabling the common citizens of our country to avail air travel. All these programs are also helping bridge the rural and urban divide. As the world's third largest domestic aviation market, the time is ripe for India to enter into aircraft financing and leasing activities from Indian shores. This is critical to the development of self-reliant aviation industry, creating aspirational jobs in aviation finance, besides leveraging the business opportunities available in India's financial special economic zones, namely International Financial Services Center, the IFSC. Government will implement the essential elements of the regulatory roadmap for making India a hub for such activities. For providing an enabling ecosystem for growth in India of maintenance, repair and overhaul, MRO, maintenance, repair and overhaul industry, it is proposed to leverage India's engineering advantage and potential to achieve self-reliance in this vital aviation segment. Government will adopt suitable policy interventions to create a congenial atmosphere for the development of MRO in the country. The new metro rail projects for a total route length of 300 kilometers have been approved during 2018 and 19. Also, during 2019, about 210 kilometers metro lines have been operationalized. With this, 657 kilometers of metro rails network has become operational across the country. 657 kilometers. India's first indigenously developed payment ecosystem for transport based on National Common Mobility Card, NCMC standards, was launched by the Honorable Prime Minister in March 2019. This will enable people to pay multiple kinds of transport charges, including metro services and toll tax, across the country. This interoperable transport card runs on RuPay card and would allow the holders to pay for their bus travel, toll taxes, parking charges, retail shopping, and even withdraw money. Phase two of the FAME scheme, following approval of the cabinet, with an outlay of 10,000 crore rupees over a period of 3 years, has commenced from 1st April 2019. The main objective of the scheme is to encourage faster adoption of electric vehicles by way of offering upfront incentive on purchase of electric vehicles and also by establishing the necessary charging infrastructure for electric vehicles. Only advanced battery and registered e-vehicles will be incentivized under the scheme, with greater emphasis on providing affordable and environment-friendly public transportation options for the common man. The government will carry out a comprehensive restructuring of the National Highway Program to ensure that the National Highway Grid of desirable length and capacity is created using financiable model. After completing the phase one of Bharatmala, in the second phase, states will be helped to develop state road networks. We need to develop our inland waterways to shift a significant portion of inland cargo movement from road and rail. This government envisions using the rivers for cargo transportation, which will also help to decongest roads and railways. As part of the Jalmarg Vikas project, for enhancing the navigational capacity of the Ganga, a multimodal terminal at Varanasi has become functional in November 2018, and two more such terminals at Sahibganj and Haldia, a navigational lock at Faraka, would be completed in 1920. The movement of cargo volume on Ganga is estimated to increase by nearly 4 times in the next 4 years. This will make movement of freight, passenger cheaper and reduce our import bill. It is estimated that railway infrastructure would need an investment of 50 lakh crores between 2018 to 2030. Given that the capital expenditure outlays of railways are around 1.5 to 1.6 lakh crores per annum, completing even all sanctioned projects would take decades. It is therefore proposed to use public-private partnership to unleash faster development and completion of tracks, rolling stock manufacturing, and also delivery of passenger freight services. To take connectivity infrastructure to the next level, we will build on the successful model in ensuring power connectivity, one nation, one grid. Earlier we spoke about one nation, one card for mobility of common man. Now it is one nation, one grid that has ensured power availability to states at affordable rates. I propose to make available a blueprint this year for developing gas grids, water grids, highways, and regional airports. So the scaling up that we talked about, which marks the USP of this government, is revealed in each one of these examples. We do it in that scale each time. The recommendations of High-Level Empowered Committee on retirement of old and inefficient plants and addressing low utilization of gas plant.
छुरी में दम है।
हेमोडेक खून बढ़ाए, शक्ति दे, सौंदर्य निखारे।